Okay, so now we've got our air mount bracket mounted to the Z head of the robot, and we are going to focus on putting together the infrastructure, the two Pico cables, the 6mm and 2 4mm hoses that are going to be used on this bracket. And to do that, we are going to open the track up on the robot to make that happen. Okay, so here are the pieces that we're going to mount on the air mount bracket. We've got two lengths of 4mm tubing, one black and one white. We've got 6mm blue urethane tubing, and we've got our Pico cable sitting here. We've also got a metric hex key set and a Phillips head screwdriver to do the install. One thing that you may want to do is take a moment and just label the connectors that are used on the Pico so that you know which end is going on the bracket. That's what the B is here, bracket, versus the ones that are going to be plugged into the back of the controller. You don't want to go through all this work and then realize you have them backwards. So take a minute and just mark the female ends of the cables for the bracket end. Okay, so part of the process here when we're doing all of this work is to assess whether or not we need to remove this tractor from the robot itself. When I'm mounting Pico cables on this robot, the connectors used on the Pico cables are big enough that they do not fit through this opening on this track. If I'm just installing air tubing, that's not a problem. I can leave everything fully mounted and just slide the tubing through the track and we're good. But if I'm doing Pico cables, I need to remove the two screws, the two Phillips head screws that mount the track to the robot frame. A word of caution here is that there's an opening immediately adjacent to those two screws, and you do not want to drop those screws into that hole. So just use some caution when you go to remove the screws so that you don't drop them in the hole. Okay, so I've removed the first screw, and now I'm going to remove the second one, and I'm going to use my finger to hold a screw on the end of the screwdriver so I don't drop it into the track. And that's it. Now this track is ready to come up and be moved around. It's not a problem. The next step is we're going to pull the track open. We're going to use the pull tab on the top of the track, and we're basically just going to pull up and slide that track back all the way down. And again, because I'm putting Pico cables on here, I need to open this all the way down to the beginning. Take this completely off. Okay, we'll put the track aside for now. And that just gives us the ability to put the cables through here. So I've got my two cables. Here are the male ends of the Pico cables. So I will pass one at a time through this opening. It's a little snug. Take your time. Don't damage the other cables that are here. There's one. There's two. Okay, so once we're done with that, we're okay. We could put the screws back in this and hold it down, but let's hold off on doing that. We're going to run the tubing through here as well. So I've got three pieces of tubing. All right, I've got two lengths of 4mm tubing, and then I've got a length of 6mm tubing. Now this is the worst possible scenario. This is the max. This is everything that can go on this setup. But again, look at the setup that you're trying to run. If you're doing something with a syringe barrel, you don't need all of this tubing. You can get away generally with using one 4mm length of tubing. If you're using a spray valve system, spray valves use both pieces of 4mm tubing, one for atomizing air, one for the actuating air on the valve. So, and the 6mm tubing is used primarily in liquidine applications. It can be used for Pico applications. If you want to downsize it with a reducer fitting, you can do that either on the inbound or on the outbound side of the fitting itself that's on the bracket. But again, we're going to install all three of these because we want to show people, you know, everything that could be possibly loaded onto this setup. But before we do that, let's go ahead and mount the Pico cables to the bracket. Okay, so let's go ahead and mount our Pico cables, and it's pretty straightforward. You're just going to lay them in the track, carry them up over the top. And again, they're going to be mounted on the bracket. So let's turn the robot and we'll show you the detail on that. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and mount our two Pico cables to this bracket. And to do that, all we're going to do is loosen the screw a little bit. We don't have to take it out completely. install the cables. It really doesn't matter, you know, there's a 3-pin and a 5 or 6-pin. It doesn't matter, but just make sure that you're looking at the female ends of those two connectors when you go to install this. If you've got the male ends up here, they're backwards. You need to stop and turn them around. Okay, so again, once I've got them through the clamp, we'll just go ahead and tighten the clamp down. So, those are nice and tight, they're not going anywhere, we're good. The next step again is to just dress it along the track and along the back of the Z head of the robot. Okay, so now we're going to go ahead and start installing our tubing into our bracket. Basically, I've got my 6mm tubing, and then I've got two lengths of 4mm tubing. And these are check valve fittings, so push the tubing in as far as you can. Get the black tubing in. Awesome. All right, so then we're just going to run this all up into the track on the top of the robot. Give yourself a little bit of a service loop here so that you can tie it off at the top of the robot. I generally would like to put it on this side, so let's do that real quick. As you can see, I've got a tremendous length of tubing here. I don't want to run short. I'd always, you know, I prefer to have more than I need and just cut it back when I'm done. So again, I've got all of my cables and all of my hoses sitting here, looking pretty, and I can tie them off so that, you know, again, they're being secured here before they go into the track. Okay, so I've got my tubing here, and we're just gonna slide it down the track. And this track is unscrewed, so we can make it real easy just by running it, taking it right to the end of the track and feeding it through, like so. And then we'll just pull the slack out of it. This is, I can easily adjust what I'm doing. Looks pretty good. A little extra black tubing. Let's pull some of that through. Awesome. All right, so we're just about ready to put the track back together. Everything's neat, tucked in, so let's work on that next. Alright, so now we're ready to put our tractor back together. I've got the tractor cover in my hand. We're going to start at the far end here where it gets mounted to the robot, and basically we're just going to snap it together. So. Okay, so we're getting to the point where the tractor's almost completely closed off, so let's snap the final couple of pieces. Slug. There we go. Alright, so that tractor is now fully closed off. Tubing looks good. Cables look good. I've got my little red tie here that I can use just to secure everything. Just wrap that up in a nice little bundle. And we are good. The only other thing we need to do is put the two screws back in it that hold it to the robot. And again, we don't want to drop the screws into the hole next to their location, so again I put a finger on the end of the screws before I put them on the screwdriver, or as I'm putting them on the screwdriver, just so I can secure them. Second screw in place. Again, this is pretty tight because we've got pico cables here and we've got 3 air hoses, so that's the worst case load. For most robot applications, you don't generally see all of this stuff used in combination. But there you go. So now we are good to go.